Hello viewers, how are you? Hope you are fine. Welcome back to my channel, Drawing Time with a Story. If you are new in my channel, I will introduce myself and my channel with you. Normally, I select a theme or an object to draw, and while drawing or painting, I just not paint or draw. At the same time, you will able to listen to story or various stories related to the topic. Or if I don't get any stories, then I will gossip you related to the topic or deliver you some information regarding the topic. So definitely you are not going to get bored. So please don't forget to subscribe my channel to stay connected with me, to stay connected with Drawing Time with Story, because it's a place of fun and entertainment. As you saw, my today's topic is painting a sunset and a beautiful sunset theme, and with the cactus. So the highlighted topic is cactus. So definitely we are going to listen to the stories related to the cactus. So our first story's name is The Story of Cactus Flower. A cactus stood all alone in the desert, wondering why it was stuck in the middle of nowhere. "I do nothing but stand here all day long," it sighed. "What use am I? I am the ugliest plant in the desert. My spines are thick and prickly. My leaves are rubbery and tough. And my skin is thick and bumpy. I can't offer shade or juicy fruit to any passing traveler. I don't see that I am any use at all." And it did was stand in the sun day after day, growing taller and fatter. Its spines grew longer and its leaves tougher, and it swelled here and there until it was lumpy and lopsided all over. It truly was strange looking, and it is weird looking too. "I wish I could do something useful," it sighed in sorrow. By day, hawks circled high overhead. "What can I do with my life?" the cactus called. It was very frustrating, and what I am doing in my life, it has no meaning to me. Whether they heard or not, the hawk sailed away. At night, the moon floated into the sky and cast its pale glow on the desert floor. "What good can I do with my life?" the cactus called. The moon only stared coldly as it mounted its course. A lizard crawled by, leaving a little trail in the sand with its tail. "What worthy deed can I do?" the cactus called. "You?" the lizard laughed, pausing a moment. "Worthy, dear? Why, you can't do anything." The hawk circled away overhead, tracing delicate patterns for us all to admire. "The moon hangs high like a lantern at night, so we can see our ways home to our loved ones. Even I, the lowly lizard, have something to do. I decorate the sands with these beautiful brush strokes as I pull my tail along. By you do nothing but get uglier every day." So it went on year after year. At last, the cactus grew old, and it knew its time was short. "Oh Lord," it cried out, "I have wandered so long and I have tried so hard. Forgive me if I have failed to find something worthy to do. I fear that now it's too late." But just then the cactus felt a strange stirring and unfolding, and it knew a surge of joy that erased all despair. At its very tip, like a sudden crown, a glorious flower suddenly opened in bloom. never had the desert known such a blossom. Its fragrance perfumed the air far and wide and brought happiness to all passing by. The butterflies paused to admire its beauty, and that night even the moon smiled when it rose to find such a treasure. The cactus heard a voice. "You have waited long," the Lord said. "The heart that seeks to do well reflects my glory and will always bring something worthwhile to the world, something in which all can rejoice, even if for only a moment." In this life, we often feel worthless, feel there is nothing useful to do, but this story tells us God already has a plan in our life and all of God's creation is visible and worthwhile. Sometimes we think that we think like cactus. But if we truly believe that God already had a plan for our lives, although initially seems useless in accordance with God's time, everything will look worthwhile. There is nothing useless and worthless in God. Now we will listen to our second story that is named The Story of a Red Rose and a Cactus. One beautiful spring day, a red rose blossomed in a forest. Many kinds of trees and plants grew there. As the rose looked around, a pine tree nearby said, "What a beautiful flower. I wish I was that lovely." Another tree said, "Dear pine, don't be sad. We can't have everything." The rose turned its head and remarked, "It seems that I am the most beautiful plant in this forest." A sunflower raised its yellow head and asked, "Why do you say that? In this forest, there are many beautiful plants. You are just one of them." The red rose replied, "I see everyone looking at me and admiring me." Then the rose looked at a cactus and said, "Look at that ugly plant full of thorns." The pine tree said, "Red rose, what kind of talk is this? Who can say what beauty is? You have thorns too." The proud red rose looked angrily at the pine and said, "I thought you had good taste. You don't know what beauty is at all. You can't compare my thorns to that of cactus." "What a proud flower," thought the trees. The rose tried to move its roots away from the cactus, but it couldn't move. As the days passed, the red rose would look at the cactus and say insulting things like, "This plant is useless. How sorry I am to be his neighbor." The cactus never got upset, and he even tried to advise the rose, saying, "God didn't create any form of life without a purpose. So everything has a purpose of life." Spring passed, so the golden days have been passed, and the weather became very, very warm. Life became difficult in the forest, as the plants and animals needed water and no rainfall. The red rose began to wilt. One day, the rose saw sparrows stick their beaks into the cactus and then fly away, refreshed. This was puzzling, and the red rose asked the pine tree what the birds were doing. The pine tree explained that the birds got water from the cactus. "Does it not hurt when they make holes?" asked the rose. "Yes, but the cactus doesn't like to see any birds suffer," replied the pine. The rose opened its eyes in wonder and said, "The cactus has water?" "Yes, you can also drink from it. The sparrow can bring water to you if you ask the cactus for help." The red rose felt too ashamed of its past words and behavior to ask for water from the cactus. But then it finally did ask the cactus for help, because it was a helpless situation. She needed the water badly. The cactus kindly agreed, and the birds filled their beaks with water and watered the rose's roots. Thus, the rose learned a lesson and never judged anyone by their appearance again. Our third story's name is Cactus Story. One day, all the flowers bloomed beautifully, but only that small cactus didn't bloom a flower. All the flowers were teasing the cactus. The sunflower said, "Hey, look, cactus doesn't have a flower. Ha ha ha, it's so ugly." The cosmos said, "You don't come close to me. You make me ugly." The tulip said, "I am so lucky that I am not cactus." The daisy said, "Ew, so ugly." Soon it was a rainy day. All plants were happily drinking water. But sunflower said, "Hey cactus, you need not drink because you can't bloom any flower." The cosmos said, "Only pretty flowers can drink the water." On hearing this, tulip and daisy started to laugh. Poor cactus kept quiet and felt sad. Cactus felt so sad that once she tried to be part of them. She tried to put anything on her, but she failed. As the hot summer approached, the garden began to dry up. All the flowers were suffering under the hot weather except the cactus. Cactus asked to her fellow flowers, "Hey, are you okay?" The sunflower told her, "The weather is too hot. I am so thirsty." The cosmos said, "Help, the sun is killing me." The tulip said, "Please water me or else I will die." The daisy cried, "I am thirsty." But all the flowers were amazed at the cactus. Finally, the sunflower asked cactus, "Why don't you feel thirsty?" "Because I have a long root that spread out just under the ground in search of water. Without leaves, less water is lost through my body, so I can store a lot of water," cactus replied. "So, if you don't mind, I have water and I can help you all." Cactus told the other flowers. Cosmos, daisy, and tulip said, "We are sorry, cactus." The sunflower said, "I am sorry, cactus. We treated you so bad and yet you were still willing to help us." Cactus replied, "No problem. I am doing what I know is right." Four of them apologized to cactus because they felt guilty of what they had done to cactus. After what had happened, all the flowers stopped teasing cactus but are proud of her for saving their lives. Suddenly, a fairy appeared in front of them. The fairy said, "I have seen what you have done to the others and I am touched by your actions. Now I am helping you to grant your wish to come true." Cactus was gifted by a flower.